FM News 101 KXL.
This is Ground Zero on FM News 101.
Everyone is in on the secrets, and big things are being planned. Call Clyde Lewis now. Ground Zero.
Let's go to Bob in Cleveland. Hi, Bob. You're on Ground Zero.
Hi.
Hey, what's up, man?
Are you guys nuts or something?
Why do you say we're nuts?
You had that Occupy Freak Show on, and he's talking about, well, the cops are letting them do this, and they swoop in and arrest them.
But he was there.
I watched it.
You watched it, Bob.
You want to see the videos? I produced 34 videos from that event. Go to Occupy. Go to Ferguson Civil Unrest and watch the 30 video playlist.
Just shut up.
Watch it yourself. Watch it yourself.
Bob.
You are just trying to...
No, actually, I'm a volunteerist.
People,
Bob.
The cop had every right to shoot
Bob.
That
I'm a volunteerist.
Bob, nobody's arguing that. Bob, nobody's arguing that.
In heaven.
Hey, Bob, I got something to say
to
you. Bob. Bob.
Then he
Bob.
Attacked a cop.
Bob.
Then he turned around
Bob.
And ran. The cop
Bob.
Shot him in the cup.
Bob,
the
take a big cup of shut the hell up
God
a minute, will you?
What is wrong
Here
with
is a big cup of shut the hell
oh,
up.
Oh, I should never
You don't tell. You don't tell.
You
don't tell. You don't tell.
Tell me.
What's
Tell
that?
Tell me, where do you get your crack? I got to know.
I don't know, but you seem to have a lot of hairy crack that's really stinking up the radio show right now. I would suggest you shut your freaking mouth and let me speak. Yeah, you turd. You hang up on my show. You call up to tell everybody to shut up and you hang up on my show. You're a real coward. You are a total coward. You are a turd. I swear. People just call up and they're like, you're so pissed off. I'm going to get pissed off. I'm not going to let them say a word. You know, look, we're not condoning any of it. We're saying that people are fed up with the police state.
Sure.
That's an objective way to put it, right?
Sure.
Nobody is saying that the police officer was wrong or right. Nobody is saying that this is a case of whether or not I'm saying that Darren Johnson made a mistake or that Mike Brown was in the wrong. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is what we're seeing, in my opinion, is the accumulation of all of this stuff that's been passed by our legislators and by our president. And then we're seeing the police officers doing what they're told to do. They're bringing in the heavy artillery. And then what we see is these protesters, basically, you know, the ones that are peaceful, they do their thing. But the ones that want to cause the trouble. The police have to harden their resolve and do what they have to do. Nobody is saying that that is right or wrong. What we're saying is it's happening. If you don't like it, fine. But listen before you open your mouth. Honk, honk, Whites Wobbles the Goose. We'll be back.
FM News 101 KXL.
More with Clyde Lewis and Ground Zero on FM News 101.
Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the yes. sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police.
Got a new one today. That's the police. Sound of the Police.
Decisions that were made over the last 8 years established an ad hoc legal approach for fighting terrorism that was neither effective nor sustainable.
Ouch. Then, moments later, he announced his own ad hoc legal approach for fighting terrorism.
There may be a number of people who cannot be prosecuted for past crimes. In some cases, because evidence may be tainted, but who nonetheless pose a threat to the security of the United States.
Creepy, right? Putting somebody in jail, not for what they've done, but for what you're very sure they're going to do? Preventive incarceration. Indefinite detention without trial. That's what this is.
I am not a terror.
Police.
There it goes there. Now firing onto the crowd. Out!
Heavily armed and armored riot police confronting sit-down strikers protesting the killing of a young African-American man, Michael Brown. Two reporters were arrested tonight under what sounds like some strange circumstances.
Are you serious?
Notice how the Obama administration always mysteriously goes from the spotlight to a backseat position. Anytime the president does something extremely controversial.
This situation is totally out of hand.
Let me give you an example. In early 2012, the President of the United States passed an anti-congressional an anti-constitutional act known as the National Defense Authorization Act, or the NDAA. This gives him, the president, the ability to detain unlawfully any American citizen he sees fit without judge, trial, or jury.
This thing is abuse of power. America is becoming a prison planet or a police state, whatever you want to say. I mean, what do you want me to do?
They're firing rubber bullets.
I'm Clyde Lewis, and you are listening to Ground Zero. The number is to call tonight, 888-673-3700. Ferguson is on fire. Many other places across the country on fire as well tonight as the response to the verdict provided by the grand jury will not indict the officer who shot Michael Brown in Ferguson, Missouri, and this has sparked a lot of protests. And tonight on the program, what we're trying to do is we're trying to speak objectively about the entire thing. I think people think that we're siding with either those who are doing the protests, or we're siding with the police, or not siding with the police enough, or no, I'm not siding with either. In fact, I find it deplorable that in times where we have such cojones to speak ill of our president, and then when we see these protests happen, that we immediately decide that anyone who speaks of the protests stating that this is part of what Barack Obama has created, we still have people that are willing to say that we're communists and we're socialists and we're whatever for saying so. It just goes to show you there is a lack of political understanding in this country, and there's a lack of people who understand the difference between authoritarianism and statism. And if you want to follow the state, go right ahead, not on my dime, because the state is going to lead you right down that path as the Pied Piper did, right to your own death. And that's how it's always been. That's how it always will be. And that's how I see it as far as despotism is concerned. You can call my guest a commie. You can call him a pink all you want, but he's not. He certainly isn't one. And you know what? If you feel that way, that's fine. But you know, you don't come on a show and insult guests, nor do you insult the integrity of this program, because we have been reporting this for months. And now that it's coming to a head, you have people who feel necessary the ability to call into this program and say that what we're doing is causing trouble. I'm not causing trouble. I'm merely stating what I had been reporting for months, and that is this was going to happen. I was wrong about one thing. I fully admit that I was wrong about one thing. I did not think that something as small as Ferguson, that something as small as a police officer shooting a black kid who stole cigarillos, was going to spark protests all over the country, including Portland, Oregon. With me is Wes Scottco, who was just downstairs doing his report for Ground Zero and for KXL, actually, of what's been going on down there. What did you see downtown tonight?
About 150 people, Portland residents. A lot of them just angry about the outcome of what happened in Ferguson. And they were all down in front of the Justice Center down on 3rd and Madison.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they had signs. Some were painted onto bed sheets. Some were made on pieces of cardboard, what have you. And they were chanting. And I got some audio recordings of the chanting. I got some video. I uploaded one of the video clips, one of the better ones, where I was really close. So I uploaded that onto the Facebook page.
Right.
And I got some audio. So if you want to play that, Clyde.
Let's play some audio now. Here we go. Obviously, this is for Michael Brown. This is to support Michael Brown, even though, you know, he apparently the police are now, or they're saying now that the police, the police officer involved was not in the wrong, which I find interesting that this is what's going on. Also, we have this.
A variety of chants that they were putting out there,
mostly though in support of Michael Brown.
Pretty much all of them, yeah.
Okay.
Referencing the Michael Brown case in some way, like hands up, heads down, things like that.
So they're literally on the side that the police officer was at fault, probably.
Yeah, that's the vibe that they gave off, was that they just feel like a kid that was innocent was shot down. I can't say for sure anything about
the case. Either.
I wasn't there. I mean, I had never heard of Ferguson, Missouri until this summer when this all went down.
Right.
So I just kind of stay on the neutral side of things.
We reported it when it wasn't even cool to report it, which I thought was interesting.
I can't tell you one thing. It's tragic.
It is tragic.
Nobody likes hearing that happen, ever.
No, they don't. I agree with you. Well, I thank you for your hard work, and the video on the Facebook page looks great. Thank you, Wes. Thank you for being a part of the show.
Thanks for having me on, Clyde.
You bet. No problem. And Mike Smith with us tonight, the commie pinko who I've allowed to come into the studio. You know, it's funny, when things like this happen and the division goes out, people tend to think that if you see injustice being served and the police are involved, you're basically blaming the police. I don't blame the police. And you were telling me, too, that you don't blame the police most of the time. You say that most of the police officers you come in contact with are not jerks.
Well, I'd like to get into that a little bit, what we're talking about during the break. is I really believe after filming the cops every weekend, sometimes Friday and Saturday, giving my weekends up for this for 2 years, I believe that people that become cops do it from a legitimate...